Have you ever wondered how the elements in the universe were formed? This question is one of the most fundamental in all of science, and physicists at Argonne National Laboratory are working to find the answer by studying the atomic nucleus. A nucleus is a tiny collection of particles at the center of an atom, the building block of all visible material in the universe. Studying the structure of nuclei and the forces that bind them together can tell us how the atoms around us came to be, especially the heavy elements like gold, platinum, and uranium, which only form when stars merge or explode. The Argonne Tandem Linac Accelerator System, or ATLAS, is one of the leading facilities in the world for the study of atomic nuclei. Housed at Argonne, this particle accelerator enables pivotal discoveries central to our understanding of matter, nuclear forces, and the origin of the elements. Although nuclei are very small, discoveries about their nature can lead to huge advances in technology we use every day. Examples include new ways to capture solar energy and produce electricity, and improvements to medical tests and treatments, such as X-rays, MRI scans, and CAT scans. At ATLAS, scientists create and accelerate beams of charged atoms called ions, ranging across the elements from hydrogen to uranium. These beams of ions travel toward the end of the accelerator, getting faster and faster until they smash into target atoms. The aftermath of these collisions contains clues about the universe for scientists to uncover. ATLAS is a linear accelerator, which means it accelerates ions down a linear beamline toward the targets. The ions travel through superconducting resonators along their path. These resonators produce strong accelerating fields. As a beam passes through each resonator, it gains more and more energy, zooming down the accelerator like a surfer riding waves to the shore. Between creation and collision, the accelerated ions travel approximately 150 yards, or the length of 1.5 football fields. In that relatively short distance, more than a billion ions per second can whiz down the accelerator at velocities up to 20% of the speed of light, or around 37,000 miles per second. When an ion beam reaches the end of the accelerator, the beam nuclei smash into the target nuclei to form new, unstable nuclei, meaning they quickly decay or fall apart. Each nuclear decay is like a one-atom explosion. It releases some energy as gamma rays or high-energy light waves, and it produces some fragments made of other particles. For example, Gammasphere, shown here, is one of ATLAS's main detector systems. It consists of 110 detectors made of germanium in a spherical arrangement, each about the size of a coffee cup. The detectors collect information from the fusion and decay of heavy ions, information like what particles came out of the collision, how fast they were moving, and what directions they traveled. This entire process is overseen from the ATLAS control room. Operators use various computers to control and monitor several hundred independent devices in real time, set alarms, and view the status of the systems, maintaining the right temperatures and other experimental conditions for the accelerator to function safely and effectively. Since 1985, researchers from all over the world have used instruments at ATLAS, around 300 to 400 researchers per year. As the accelerators have gotten more powerful and ATLAS has gotten new features, researchers have been able to detect and study increasingly rare and exotic particles and nuclei. ATLAS research is not limited to fundamental questions like the origin and evolution of the universe or its elements. It can be applied to countless areas of practical innovation. For example, ion beams can help scientists study how biological samples react to radiation therapy and even make radioisotopes for other emerging medical uses. They can also be used to test how well materials and sensors used in space exploration can handle radiation and to investigate new materials for use in next-generation power plants. New developments like these may take 10 years or much longer to find their way from basic science to practical application. But in the meantime, scientists are using ATLAS to advance the fundamental understanding of the physical world around us and stand ready to help develop future technologies. For more information, visit www.anl.gov/atlas.